Start your
fans, we are here live at Daytona International Speedway for the running of the Subway Jalapeno 250 powered by Coca-Cola. This is probably going to be one of the longest races of the season. Let's take a look at the top 10 starting lineup. Row 1, we have Ryan Acosta and Zohar Mutton. Row 2, we have Pichu London and Evan Brinker. Row 3, we have Robert Brooks and Cody Lamas. Row 4, we have Adam Feigl and Bronny Ward. Rounding out the top 10 is Tim Schell and Jake Baskinger. As we get ready to hear those famous words in motorsports,
drivers, start your engines!
Drivers are firing up those cars. Let's see if anyone's going to have any problems. Uh-oh. Oh, Ralph Green. Ralph Green has gone to pit road. He couldn't get his car started. And he's the only one. That is not what Ralph Green needed. He has been trying so hard to get a good run, but he's like the definition of bad luck right now. Oh, another car is having problems. That's Hunter Combs in the 33. Oh man, Hunter Combs is going to be coming down pit road now. Maybe he has a problem too, as we're already going green. We're going to be doing this for 50 laps, and we already have two cars having troubles. And whoa, Zohar Mutton, he got to run off of the high side, but he can't get down in front of Ryan Acosta because that 38 car is moving. There's a little bit of three wide in the back. He got a push from Evan Brinker from the outside. Whoa, I heard scraping. I think a car is scraping the wall. Oh, it's Jenny Castro, and she's gonna lose the pack. That's not what she needed. Leading this first lap is gonna be Zohar Mutton. Ryan Acosta, he's coming up behind him. He's still being pushed by Pichu London. Whoa, Robert Brooks, he tried to decide if he wanted to go outside or inside, and he stayed on the inside, so that was a smart move. Adam Feigl, he's running in fifth now. Whoa! Oh, we got trouble! Trouble in the back! Oh, man, Tim Frelick, last week's winner, Callum Wells, Aaron Reed, Connor Breeden, Alexander Dawson, and Tim Feigl. And I believe that's going to bring out the caution. Yep, it does. Yellow flag is out. We had a few cars go around. Callum Wells has rear damage. Tim Feigl has side damage. And leading them to the line, I believe it's Ryan Acosta. Yep, it was Ryan Acosta. And I just saw that Ralph Green is coming back onto the track. As we have our first caution, let's take a look and see what happened here. Here's what happened to brought out the first caution. It looks like, excuse me, it looks like Connor Breeden turns the 19 of Tim Feigl, and that makes him get into the 51 of Nicholas Wilson. And Nicholas Wilson, he gets into the 16 of Callum Wells. And all the smoke is too much smoke to tell what. Oh, okay, the camera changed. Tim Frelick hits the wall. It looks like Travis Mitchell and Jack Richards get into it too, but I don't see any damage on their cars. As the rest of the car try to avoid him, Callum Wells has real damage. It looks like he got hit by Aaron Reed in the 99. And Alexander Dawson, he hit the wall head first in the 5 car. And there's Jenny Castro, who lost the pack after scraping the wall. She avoids all this. Let's take a look at this from Jack Richards' point of view, because he was right in front of all this. Okay, this is what Jack Richards saw. How did he avoid all that? He just barely misses hitting the 99 of Aaron Reed. That's good driving by the 15. Let's take a look at this from another point of view. Okay, here's a view from the 4 of Travis Mitchell. He was right behind Jack Richards when this happened. Travis Mitchell drove away without a single scratch on his car. Let's take one more look at this before we head back to the restart. Okay, here's the rear view from rookie Charles Jackson in the 52 car. He was in front of all that mess, so he didn't get hit. Let's take you back to the restart now. And here we are back at Daytona getting ready for the restart. Ralph Green is 2 laps down. I'm going to give a top 10 rundown. Ron Acosta, P2 London, Zohar Mutton, Tim Schell, Pat Acosta, Robert Brooks. Crap, I got a brain fart right now. Peter Paluzzi, Adam Feigl, Alex Drayton, and Evan Brinker. That's your top 10. It's been taking the restart. And of course, Ralph Green's car, it might not be up to speed, but we'll see. As right now, Ron Acosta is trying to use it for leverage as he is taking the lead now. And I bet Ralph Green is going to hold up the entire inside line if his car's not up to speed right now. P2 London is on the high side with no help. But Peter Paluzzi is coming. And now Ralph Green moved to the high side. And whoa, I think I saw a couple cars go around. Oh no, I didn't. It's just a false alarm. There's a lot of cars scrambling back here. There's Travis Mitchell in the 4. There's 2 cars trying to work out a little tango. That's Wilson Kennedy and Jeremy Britt. See who else I see. And look at Zohar Mutton. He has caught up to Ron Acosta. He's trying to make a move on him. Ron Acosta leads yet another lap as he goes to the inside now. Oh, and coming up behind Ryan Acosta is Tim Schell in the 44. Tim Schell, he won back at Texas. Here comes Robert Brooks on the inside, who had that real bad hit last week at Road America. Let's go to his hood camera. It's Robert Brooks, he's making it 3 wide per second. And he is trying to come up behind that 38 car of Ryan Acosta. He's going to try to challenge for the lead. On that 38 car, but that 38 car is putting the block in. Whoa. There's a lot of 3 wide racing back here. There's Matthew Rodriguez in the 82, along with Tim Schell in the 44. He's dropping back. And whoa. There's lots of cars scrambling. There's Trent Donham, who just made it to the high side. And there's Evan Brinker in the 88, our Las Vegas winner. And now he's helping Robert Brooks to the lead now. Whoa! Adam Chambers almost turns Trent Donner, but he saves it. Whoa, that would have been bad. Whoa, that was close. Whoa, almost 3 wide across the line. Robert Brooks, he led the lap. But here comes Evan Brinker. Right now, he's being pushed by Joseph Lombar in the three car running that, still running that Avacare scheme. Whoa. And Trent Dunham, he is wearing high side. I bet he is not happy with that 28 car right now. Let's take a look at Trent Dunham's hood camera. Right now, he's jumping behind the 28. Maybe Trent Dunham's thinking about taking him out. And Robert Brooks is scraping the wall. Caution's out. I think we had another crash because the caution's out. We had another crash, I think. Evan Brinker's going to lead them to the line. And yes, we had another wreck. Oh, Tim Schell! Who else is involved? And Dylan Poteet. Oh, man. There's another guy who has the definition of bad luck. Dylan Poteet. As his car is smoking and he is going to coast down pit road. Something happened between him and Tim Schell as while Robert Brooks scraped the wall. And Dylan Poteet has retired out of the race. We're going to have to check and see what happened here as we have our second caution of the night. Okay, here's what brought out the second caution. While we were looking at Trent Dunham's hood camera, this happened right behind him. Ryan Acosta and Tim Schell and Pete Ulunda, they were all scraping the wall until Alex Drayden, he clips the left rear of Tim Schell. And then that in turn takes him out along with the 20 of Tyler Williams. But I believe Tyler Williams saved himself, even though he scraped the wall a little bit. Because he slams on the brakes and he tries to avoid Tim Schell, and he does. As Tim Schell comes back, and Zohar Mutton. Whoa, that caused Tim Schell to flip. Zohar Mutton flipped as well. Oh, man, the 62 car. And, Dylan Poteet. Dylan Poteet, he almost avoids it, but then he just hits him just a little bit, and that just ruined his day. When he recollected himself, his car just started to smoke. And Dylan Poteet, he almost avoided it. Wow. Whoa. And to add insult to injury, his teammate Connor Breeden scrapes up on him. I don't know what that was for. We're going to have let's take a look at this from Tim Frelick's point of view, because he was right in front of Dylan right behind Dylan Poteet. Okay, this is the hood camera from Tim Frelick. As you can see, some of the cars are starting to spin out. There's Tim Schell coming down. Tim Frelick slows down, and then he gets to Dylan Poteet from the side. Cost him to give a little bit of damage. And here we are back at Daytona getting ready for the restart. And Justin Acosta has gone down under the apron. Apparently, I believe he's having engine problems with his car. That's going to be a tough break for that one team. They were running in 13, almost making it into the top 10. I'm going to give a top 10 rundown right now. Evan Brinker, Danny Wells, Luke Walker, Charles Jackson, Matthew Rodriguez, Nick Knotts, Das Kablonde, Chevy Gillian, Barney Ward, and Joseph Lombard. That's your top 10 right now. As the pace car is leaving the track, Ralph Green, he's still running in dead, he's not running in dead last anymore, but he's still two laps down. As we're getting ready for our second restart, green flag is out. Evan Brinker, he immediately gets a run on the outside, but he's being pushed by Danny Wells. Evan Brinker hasn't had a win since Las Vegas, and he's going to try to win Daytona tonight as we're on lap 15. There's still plenty of racing to go. And Nick Knotts and Luke Walker, they're both moving down to the inside, trying to make a move. Another car scraped the ball. Charles Jackson. And that that's gonna make him lose a few spots. That is not what he needed. Come to the line, Evan Ricker. He's gonna lead in a lap. And there goes Matt Wells, who had that real bad hit back at Road America. Oh no, somebody's blowing up. Oh, Peter Paluzzi's blowing up. Oh, that's a tough break for that 31 car. Just entering turn one, Peter Paluzzi blows up. As he has gone down under the apron, and we're still going green. Oh, that's a tough break for that 31 car. He was running strong. He was running in 11th. Well, he's not going to be able to finish this race. As we head back to the front, it's still all about Evan Brinker, but soon they're going to catch up to Justin Acosta. Apparently, he took a pit stop, but he's back on the track now, but he's going to get lapped pretty soon by this pack of cars. And Evan Brinker, he's still the race leader. Coming up behind him is Joseph Lombard and Pat Acosta in the 14. Here comes Red Bell right behind her in the black car of Ralph Green. Let's go to Ralph Green's hood camera. Uh-oh, looks like Justin Lombard trying to make a move on the inside of Evan Brinker for the lead. He's going to get help from Red Bell. Ralph Green, his car is up to speed. He just needs to get in front of the pack and he wants his lap back. As we head to the line, Justin Lombard led that lap, but they're about to catch the one car of Justin Acosta. And Justin Lombard, he doesn't know what he wants to do. He immediately goes to the middle of the road, but I don't think that was a good move, because Justin Acosta's blocking him. Uh-oh. Oh, and Justin Lombard, he's desperately trying to get out of the way, but that one car is blocking him. As Evan Brinker took the lead from the outside, now he's on the inside. I bet Justin Lombard is not happy with that one car right now, as he is now forced on the outside. Evan Brinker is leading, coming up behind him in second is Red Bell. Whoa! Uh-oh! Uh-oh! A couple cars got turned in the front stretch. And that's going to break out the caution. Oh, Danny Wells, Ryan Acosta, Alex Drayton. Whoa, somebody's upside down. Oh, it's Robert Brooks. And whoa. Oh, Alexander Dawson flipped him back up on his wheels. Oh, you don't see that every day. Oh man, we have our third caution. Ryan Acosta, he is scraping the wall. We had a couple cars turn on the wall. And whoa, Pat Acosta. He's not too happy with Danny Wells right now. There's Trent Dunham, there's Chevy Gilliam, there's Matt Wells, there's Joseph Lombard, there's Barney Ward, and there's Adam Chambers in the 28. I don't see a scratch on his car. There's Jake Baskinger, Cody Lamas, Luke Walker has a little damage. Well, we gotta take a look and see what happened here. As we have our third caution of the night. And here's having to brought out our third caution. It looks like Pat Acosta tried to go down onto the track, and he gets right in front of Joseph Lombard in the three, and he also gets tagged by the one of Justin Acosta, who was already a lap down. And then some more stuff happened. More stuff happened behind this pack. And well, Travis Mitchell, he almost gets into the back of Joseph Lombard, but he didn't. And whoa, Adam Feigl, he gets into Ryan Acosta, and then Alex Drayton, he gets into the 14, and then that made Robert Brooks get hit. And that's what caused him to slide on his roof. There goes Connor Breeden and Callum Wells and Tim Feigl coming into the picture, as well as Hunter Collins, but a big crash in the front stretch brought out our third caution. And here comes Alexander Dawson. He just slams into the back of the two car. And that just flips him right back on his wheels, and he drives away from it. That was kind of unbelievable. Let's take a look at this from another point of view. Okay, here's a look from the lap car of Justin Acosta. This is what he saw. Justin Acosta, he got a little bit of damage from that, but he escaped somehow. As we see, Barney Ward go deep into the grass to avoid all this. Okay, here's one more view from Chevy Gilliam, because he was in the middle of all this. He slows down enough to not hit Justin from the bar, and there's... back at Daytona getting ready for the restart with another update. It looks like Tim Fogle is blowing up. It looks like Tim Fogle is not going to be able to finish this race in the 19 car. He was running in, let's see, he was running in 26. So that's got to be a real bad blow for him. I'm going to give a top 10 rundown. Evan Brinker, Charles Jackson, Matthew Rodriguez, Red Bell, Nick Knotts, Cody Lamas, Luke Walker, Jake Baskinger, Adam Chambers, and Barney Ward. That's your top 10. Ralph Green is still two laps down, and Justin Acosta is a lap down. Check on the cars out of the rest as we're taking the restart. Peter Paluzzi is out, Alex Drayton is out, Pat Acosta is out, Robert Brooks is out, and Zohar Munn is out from that first wreck, so that's it. Restart Evan Brinker. He's using his opportunity to pull away. He's using both Ralph Green and Justin Acosta as leverage. It's Charles Jackson. He goes on the outside with no help, and trying to help him is Red Bell now. We ain't even past the halfway mark yet. We're about to, but we already had three cautions. So let's see. There's Cody Lamas in the 16th. And coming up behind Cody Lamas is the 89 of Barney Ward. And a couple of cars took pit stops. Let's go to the back of the pack. Okay, here's a couple slow cars. Das Kablunde, Gini Castro, Nicholas Wilson, and Joseph Lombard. And here's another pack of Danny Wells, Aaron Reed, and Tim Frelick in the 22. To drop out, even though he slammed Robert Brooks hard, as we see Connor Breeden now moving to the inside. Let's head back up here. That's Ryan Acosta, who decided to stay in the race. He's trying to. Oh, we got trouble again! Tyler Williams, Jake Baskinger, and Luke Walker. And man! More cars are flipping. Tyler Williams flipped, Adam Fogle gets hit, and Connor Breeden flips. Oh, man! Caution is out again. Danny Wells, Jack Richards, Connor Breeden flips. Our fourth caution of the day. And Tim Frelick, he also got into it, as well as Hunter Combs. I saw Luke Walker going around as we have our fourth caution, I believe. Whoa, both Danny Wells and Jack Richards are smoking. This is a wreck fest. You don't normally see these kind of wrecks at Daytona. And Evan Brinker, he is still leading. We gotta take a look and see what happened to Luke Walker. And here's what happened about the fourth caution. It looks like Adam Chambers strikes again. Earlier he tried to take out Trent Dunham, but he failed. Now this time he takes out Luke Walker, and he got away with it. He turns Luke Walker, and that makes him get into Tyler Williams in the 20 car. And Jake Baskinger, he had nowhere to go. He couldn't go anywhere. As Adam Chambers moves down low, and Trent Dunham, he didn't like that. And he is following him. But as we see, Tyler Williams, Jake Baskinger, and whoa, Tyler Williams, he got hit by his own teammate, Connor Breeden. And Adam Feigl, he got a little hit from Tyler Williams as Connor Breeden flipped. And there's Callum Wells. He is under that 20 car. Hunter Combs, he slammed into the 21 car as Aaron Reed avoids this. Jake Baskinger is hit. His teammate Danny Wells got into it as Connor Breeden, he flips some more. Whoa, this wreck happened at different times. I'm going to have to look at some different views about this. Okay, here's a view of the Tyler Williams wreck. He gets hit by Adam Feigl and Wilson Kennedy, and then Callum Wells. He tried to avoid it, but he had nowhere to go. And that's how Jack Richards got involved, because he couldn't slam the brakes in time. That's from Tyler Williams. And here's from Jake Baskinger. He gets rear-ended by his own teammate, Danny Wells. And then there's Tim Frelick in the 22 sliding. As those cars come to rest under the apron. And now I'm trying to get a view of what of between the Joe Gibbs cars. Okay, here's a view from the 99 of Aaron Reed. He avoided all of this. Good job about the 99, you know, he scraped the wall a little bit. And that smoking car right there, I believe that was the 04 of Wilson Kennedy. Wow. Daytona is a bad mess tonight. And here we are back at Daytona, get ready for the restart again. I'm going to give another top 10 rundown. Evan Brinker, Charles Jackson, Nick Knotts, Barney Ward, Chevy Gilliam, Cody Lamas, Travis Mitchell, Matt Wells, Pichu London, and Jeremy Britt. That's your top 10. And check on the cars involved in that accident. Tim Frelick is out. Connor Breeden is out. Jack Richards is out. Bruce Kenny is out. Jake Baskinger is out. Adam Feigl is out. Tyler Williams is out. Callum Wells is out. And Danny Wells is out. And Hunter Collins, he just retired from broken tires. As we're taking the restart, and Evan Brinker, he's doing it yet again. He really wants that second win. Next time out, we're going to have 20 laps to go. Let's hope we don't have another big one. This is probably going to be one of my longest races on YouTube. As we see Nick Knotts at 87 hanging on to third on the outside. He is using those cars, those lap cars, as leverage, and he is just trying to do his best to pull away. As we already see, some of the packs have separated. There's Joseph Lombard right by himself. There's Aaron Reed in the 99, and then there's the second pack of five cars: Alexander Dawson, Nicholas Wilson, Jenny Castro, that's Capone and Luke Walker. And that's it. And Evan Brinker, he continues to lead. And here comes Nick Knotts in the 87 car. He's trying to catch up to the 88. That's Ralph Green. He goes way out of the outside. Here comes Barney Ward. Another car scraping the wall. I'm trying to see who it is. It's Cody Lamas. He really needs to get off that wall. Him and Trent Dunham are falling behind. Here comes Trent Dunham's teammate, Joseph Lombard. He's trying to catch up. Here comes Nick Knotts making a move for the lead. He's trying to take it away from Evan Brinker, and he does with help from Ralph Green and Barney Ward. Nick Knotts is the new race leader. Ralph Green, he desperately trying to get one of his last bag. He's not running in 24. Now he goes to the inside trying to get his last bag. It's almost like he's racing for the lead, but really the real race for the lead is between Nick Knotts and Matthew Rodriguez. Matthew Rodriguez, he's going for the lead now. He will lead this lap. Matthew Rodriguez leads his lap, but here comes Red Bell on the inside. She's being pushed by Matt Wells. And whoa, more of the packs have separated now. Cody Lamas, Trent Dunham, and Joseph Lombard. They're desperately trying hard to catch up to these packs of cars, and they're falling way behind. Only way they can catch up is if another caution comes out. As we see Charles Jackson and Ryan Acosta back here. It's still all about Matthew Rodriguez, though. Let's go to his rear camera and see what he sees. Matthew Rodriguez, he led another lap. Here comes Jeremy Grant in the 12 car. Look at Jeremy Grant's face. He is desperately trying to make a move on that 82 car. He wants to lead. Jeremy Grant has had much success in the Moto1 Nationwide Series. And whoa, 3-wide. Whoa, 3-wide for the lead. And Pete Ulunda's going to take advantage of it. Pete Ulunda has taken the lead, and I believe another car is scraping the wall. And it's Nick Knotts. Uh-oh. And leading this lap is going to be Pete Ulunda. But here comes our last Daytona winner, Travis Mitchell. Travis Mitchell wants to try to get his third win. When we had our first Daytona race, he won under a last lap pass. Coming behind Travis Mitchell now is Chevy Gillian in the 70. Surprisingly clean racing so far. This is anybody's race up here. And here comes Ryan Acosta trying to bounce back on points leader. He's been involved in two cautions. He has a damaged car and he is running in second. Ryan Acosta, he's trying to get his first win. His brother Pat Acosta already has a win. Here comes Barty Ward in the 89. He won in his debut race back at Nashville. As Travis Mitchell continues to lead. We have 15 laps to go. Anything can happen in 15 laps. Let's go to the rear and see who else we see. There's Nicholas Wilson running by himself. He's running in 22nd. He's the last car on the lead lap. There's Das Kablunde, Jenny Castro, and Aaron Reed back here. And there's a battle for position between Luke Walker and Alexander Dawson. They're battling for 17th. There's Joseph Lombard running by himself. And there's Trent Dunham and Cody Lamas still running together. And also there's Nick Knotts and the lap car of Justin Acosta. We head back to the pack. And Pete Ulunda, he's dropped way back. And Barty Ward led the last lap. He's taking the lead again. Barty Ward has taken the lead, but he is being pushed by Red Bell and Matthew Rodriguez. And Evan Bricker, he's hanging back in fifth. He wants to try to get his second win of the season. Let's go to his hood camera. Right now, he's trying to drop behind that 82 car of Matthew Rodriguez, and he's about to take away third from Red Bell. Evan Bricker hasn't won a race since Las Vegas, and he's going to try to go for second as he forces Matthew Rodriguez on the high side. He's trying to catch that 89 car. The 88 and the 89 running first and second. Uh-oh. It looked like Red Bell almost tried to take out Matthew Rodriguez, but he said, Oh, man. Whoa. Good bumping back there. Oh, Charles Jackson's flipping. Oh, man. Oh, my gosh. Charles Jackson. Oh, my gosh. Whoa. That's going to bring out our fifth caution. And racing back to the line, Barty Ward led the lap as he gets a little rush from P2 London. Oh my gosh, Charles Jackson. Whoa, we gotta take a look and see what happened here. They were just bumping together in the back straightaway. Oh my gosh. Let's take a look and see what happened to Charles Jackson. Okay, I'm trying to see where this began. Okay, it began with Jeremy Britt almost turning red bell. Ralph Green is forced to go at the bottom of the racetrack, and then Jeremy Britt, he bounces off the sixth car of Matt Wells, and then Ralph Green and Charles Jackson, they both hit the wall, and then Chevy Gilliam gets turned by Travis Mitchell, and Matt Wells also gets turned, and Red Bell, she just slams into the side of Charles Jackson, and I'm trying to count, he flipped, that was two, he flipped, let's see, three, four, five, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Charles Jackson flipped 18 times across the backstretch. Oh my gosh. Wow, that was insane. We're going to have to take a look and see what happened here. Let's go to Ralph Green's hood camera and see how this happened. And here we are riding on board with Ralph Green. This is the best view of the wreck we can get. As Ralph Green slams hard into the wall. And there's Charles Jackson's flip. As you can see right there in plain view. Oh my gosh. As Charles Jackson, he just comes to rest right back on his wheels. Didn't appear to be moving in the car. It's probably going to have to be airlifted to the hospital. Okay, here we are riding on board with Charles Jackson in his cockpit. Oh, he's the one that actually turned Ralph Green, and then that's when he got hit by Red Bell, and he is just flipping non-stop. Some odd miracle, he ends up back on his wheels. Wow. Charles Jackson. Okay, here we are back at Daytona, and we're under a red flag condition for them cleaning up all of the mess that came from the wreck back there and Charles Jackson's big flip down the backstretch. I'm going to give a top 10 rundown. Barney Ward, Evan Brinker, P2 London, Matthew Rodriguez, Ryan Acosta, Adam Chambers, Jeremy Britt, Nick Knotts, Cody Lamas, and Travis Mitchell. That's your top 10. I'm going to give an update on Charles Jackson's condition, and we're going to take a quick break and be back in time for the restart. Okay, here we are back at Daytona, getting ready for the restart as we are back under yellow. I already gave a top 10 rundown. Charles Jackson has been taken to the nearest hospital after he was in the infield care center. He will have a DNF in 23rd from his accident. And also, Ralph Green has finally retired out of the race. And Chevy Gilliam is also retired out of the race with a broken gearbox. Excuse me. We have 21 cars left on the field, and we're going to restart with 8 laps to go. A lot can happen in 8 laps, and there's no lap cars to slow anybody down. Barney Ward is going to try to go for his second win. Evan Briggs is going to try to go for his second win. And P2 London is trying to get his first. As we're back racing, Evan Brinker, he's not wasting any time. He's already going on the inside of Barney Ward. And he's got it. Here to look at the four car, Travis Mitchell. Travis Mitchell is going to attempt to make NASCAR Mobile 1 Nationwide Series history as is going to be the first driver to sweep a track. But right now he's going to have to get to the low side if he wants to do that. Whoa! Oh, whoa, Jeremy Britt. He almost got turned by Trent Dunham, but he saved it. Whoa, Trent Dunham, he must really want to get to the front. That's a big no-no for Trent. As we head back to the front, whoa, it looks like Matthew Rodriguez, he's taking the lead. But look who's behind him. Adam Chambers in the 28. Matthew Rodriguez better be careful if he doesn't want to get taken out as he goes to the outside now. And whoa, it looks like Peachy Lunch is trying to make it 3 wide again. And he does. That's like the third time Peachy Lunch has made it 3 wide in this race. And also trying to come back up is Nick Knotts in the 87. Remember, he scraped the wall earlier and he was way in the back of the pack. Some of the packs are trying to lose. It's all about Matthew Rodriguez. The last time the 82 crossed off victory lane, it was back at Talladega with Johnny Gardner behind the wheel before he was released. And 3 cars are trying to break away from the pack now. Matthew Rodriguez, Peachy London, and Nick Knotts. But this other pack is trying to catch him. And there goes Nick Knotts on the inside trying to make a move. But Matthew Rodriguez puts the block in as Peachy London now goes high. All that thought was a good move. Nick Knotts, he is running in second right now, but Barney Ward trying to close in. And also trying to come in is Cody Llamas. Cody Llamas is trying to get his second win after he won at Talladega. He won at Darlington. But now he goes to the outside. And now Evan Brinker's trying to come back as well as Barney Ward. But right now, Matthew Rodriguez, he's doing whatever he can to protect that lead. He's doing anything he can possibly do. And but here comes Barney Ward. Barney Ward's moving to the inside. Remember, Barney Ward had that real bad flip at Dover. He's already confirmed that he's going to race in the AAA 400 in the second cup. And for him to win at Daytona, it would be a big momentum booster for him. And, well, Peachy London, he is on the bumper of Evan Brinker. He almost spun him out. Matthew Rodriguez, he's got to run on the high side as he led that lap, and he goes back on the inside in front of Barney Ward. Oh, that 82 car is powerful. That 82 car wants to get back in victory lane for the second time. This is under a new driver, a dual driver actually. Both Matthew Rodriguez and Matthew McMurray both share this ride. And for them to win at Daytona, that would be something. Matthew McMurray is watching from the pits right now. Rodriguez just got passed by Barney Ward and Adam Chambers. This time I'm going to have 3 laps to go. As Barney Ward leads, but here comes Cody Llamas and Travis Mitchell in the 4. If Travis Mitchell can win under a last lap pass, that would be history again. But right now, it's all about Barney Ward now, as we have 3 laps to go. And, well, these drivers, they are really driving hard. They better not cause another wreck, because if they do, the race is over. Let's see in the back. There's Nicholas Wilson and Das Capande. There's Matt Wells in the 6. There's Matthew Rodriguez, teammate Jimmy Castro. There's Aaron Reed, Red Bell, Jeremy Britt. Joseph Lombard trying to battle it out with Luke Walker and Alexander Dawson. There's Ryan Acosta by himself. There's Trent Dunham by himself in 9th. As we head back to the front. This time, Bob, we're going to have 2 laps to go. If Barney Ward can protect his lead for just 2 laps, he'll have his second win of the season. But here comes Cody Llamas at 60. Don't count him out yet. And also, watch out for Travis Mitchell. He can pull off an upset. You know what? If you think about it, both of Travis's Mitchell's victories came under a last lap pass. Let me go to Travis Mitchell's hood camera. Right now he is on the bumper of Cody Llamas and he's going to try to go to the inside. And I think he is. Yeah, Travis Mitchell, he's going to the inside and he's going to try to go for that 89 car. Travis Mitchell trying to go for the Daytona sweep. Right now he has walk on passing Barney Ward for that position, as we're now coming to the white flag. Buddy Ward takes the white flag, and Travis Mitchell is coming up behind him. Buddy Ward better do what he can to protect his lead from that 4 car, because that 4 car is coming, and also coming up is the 87 car. And look at these 4 cars battling it out. They're going single file down the best of the way. Uh-oh, Nick Noss is making a move. But Barney Ward puts the block in. And Travis Mitchell, he goes to the outside. The 3 wide behind him. That's not what they wanted to do. That's going to make Barney Ward pull away. But here comes Nick Noss and Pichu London. But I don't think they're going to have enough time. They're coming out of turn 4 right now. Barney Ward is blocking the inside line. As Barney Ward will win the Subway Jalapeno 250. Barney Ward captures his second win of the NASCAR Mobile One Nationwide Series. After coming off a real bad injury at Dover, Barney Ward comes back and he wins at Daytona. How about that? Coming in second is Nick Knotts. Coming in third is Pichu London. Fourth is Adam Chambers. Fifth is Evan Brinker. Sixth is Cody Lamas. Seventh is Matthew Rodriguez. Eighth is Travis Mitchell. Ninth is Trent Dunham all the way back here. And rounding out the top 10 is Ryan Acosta. What a race. Justin Acosta, he just slammed it to the 88. Whoa, what was that all about? Whoa, I don't know if there's some bad blood there or what, but Justin Acosta, he just took out Evan Brinker. Well, congratulations to Barney Ward for winning at Daytona. Oh man, what a race. The Subway Jalapeno 250 powered by Coca-Cola at Daytona. We had 5 cautions for 20 laps, and we had 11 lead changes. Barney Ward, he drove his heart out in that 89 car, and he captures his second win of the Mobile One Nationwide Series. Nick Noss started 36, and he ends up in second, coming so close. Pichu London, he pretty much finished where he started in third. Adam Chambers ends up fourth. Evan Brinker rounds out the top 5. Travis Mitchell, he started in this race dead last, and he almost got the Daytona sweep. Trent Dunham ends up in ninth. Rounding out the top 10 is Ryan Acosta, the pole sitter, after being involved in 2 cautions. And here's the rest of the field. Pretty much the rest of the field, they were involved in accidents. And here are the point standings after 17 races. We just had our mid-season finale. Well, that's going to do it for Daytona. We'll see you next time at Kentucky.